On May 18, 1980, the largest explosive eruption of the 20th century within the lower 48 U.S. states began, as a towering plume of ash rose to a height of 24 kilometers or 79,000 feet, part of Mount St. Helens collapsed to the north in a massive lateral blast and landslide. Over the next several minutes, this would go on to burn all vegetation up to 19 miles or 31 kilometers from its source. What had just occurred was a massive volcanic eruption, rating the volcanic explosivity index as a 5, representing an unusually large event. Generally speaking, volcanoes which have produced eruptions of this magnitude since the last ice age are well known. These include volcanoes such as Katla, Taupo, Mount Etna, and El Chichon. Yet, within Alaska, a surprisingly high number of volcanoes have produced eruptions of this magnitude within the last 10,000 years, but few people have heard of most of them. One of these lesser-known volcanoes which produced an eruption essentially equal in size to the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens was the Dana volcano far southwest of Anchorage. The Dana volcano is located on the far southern end of the Aleutian Peninsula, where it is 35 miles northwest of the city of Sand Point. This volcano has a medium-sized edifice whose summit stands at 1,354 meters or 4,442 feet above sea level. This volcano contains a 1 mile wide and 1.25 mile wide depression in its center, but surprisingly enough, this is not a caldera. Instead, it represents an unusually large volcanic crater which formed through repeated, highly explosive eruptions that did not involve enough magma to cause caldera collapse. Although it is difficult to tell due to the low satellite resolution of the area, this massive crater contains a crater lake. Like the other volcanoes on the Aleutian Peninsula, Dana owes its existence to the same geologic setting. To the east of the island, the Pacific Plate is colliding with and subducting underneath the North American Plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards until it erupts onto the surface, forming a chain of volcanoes. Although the exact age of the Dana volcano is unclear, it is safe to assume that it has been erupting intermittently for many tens of thousands of years. This has constructed a series of now highly eroded, overlapping lava domes and volcanic cones. These were constructed out of layers of ash and basaltic andesite, and dacite composition lavas. Many of these eruptions produce viscous lobes of lava which traveled up to several miles beyond the crater rim. However, based on the level of erosion at Dana, it appears that either this volcano is nearing the end of its lifespan, or in recent times it has erupted quite infrequently. The only documented eruption from this volcano occurred in 1890 BCE, when a Plinian eruption column likely shot over 20 kilometers into the sky. Part of the eruption column then collapsed downwards, resulting in highly energetic pyroclastic flows which were largely funneled to the south, southwest, and west, likely traveling beyond 5 miles distant. These pyroclastic flows partially filled adjacent valleys with several feet of material, potentially representing what may have even been a lateral eruption. In many ways, the products produced by this eruption look somewhat similar to the thick layers of ash produced by the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. In total, the eruption from Dana produced 1 cubic kilometer of tephra and was assigned a volcanic explosivity index of a 5. Although this volcano appears to have recently had a very low eruptive frequency, it still poses a threat to both nearby settlements and air traffic. Any form of a future explosive eruption could ground aircraft over a wide radius on or near the peninsula, and particulates of falling ash from an eruption could temporarily contaminate regional drinking water. As a result of this and other hazards, the US Geological Survey designated Dana as a moderate threat volcano. For those of you in my audience who wish to learn about a very similar volcano within Alaska that has also produced a recent VEI-5 eruption, check out my video on the Yantarni volcano. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube member, Jason Parrott, for supporting this channel.